Configuring the GS4 drive for sensorless vector mode is quick and easy. If you want to learn more about the difference between volts, hertz, and sensorless vector, then click on the information banner in the upper right corner. It'll take you to a brief video that explains the difference and when to use each mode. Now, before you configure the drive for sensorless vector mode, be sure to run the Autotune. It's quick and easy, and it'll help you maximize the performance of the drive, which can save you money. Again, click on the info banner in the upper right corner to see that video. Great, we'll assume our auto tuning is done, so let's configure the drive for sensorless vector mode. All you have to do is go to parameter 211 and set it to a 1. That's it, you're done. The drive will now automatically track and maintain its output frequency. There are a couple things you need to be aware of. First, if you use slip compensation to tweak the performance of the drive, make sure you do it after setting the drive for sensorless vector mode. Each time you set the drive for sensorless vector, slip compensation gets set to a 1. So be sure to update that after you switch the mode. And just an FYI, if you are using slip compensation, you can also specify that if the slip deviates and gets too large for a certain amount of time, what the drive should do. That's a nice feature. Remember to set the slip compensation after setting the acceleration and current parameters. Slip is a function of torque, and torque is usually the greatest during acceleration, which is also when you'll be most likely to hit the current overload, so it's important to set those before tweaking the compensation. We used parameter 211 to set the sensorless vector mode. If you look at the description of that parameter in the manual, you'll see block diagrams showing how the volts, hertz, and the sensorless vector modes operate. What I really like about these diagrams is they also show you all the pertinent parameters that you'll want to use for each function. The volts hertz setup, the motor parameters you need to set, the slip compensation, the automatic voltage regulation, etc. I love that handy reference. Well, that's all there is to it. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn more about Automation Direct's free support options, and click here to subscribe to Automation Direct's YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.